Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today I'm going to show you a quick piano technique using FL keys. I'm going to show you how to make the sound more realistic and more appealing to the ear. So by default, you know, it's a decent piano, but we can make it sound cooler. So let's learn ways to make the sound cooler so you can customize your sound. Okay, so firstly, what we're going to do is route this to the mixer. Under track one. Now let's create like a chord progression real quick. Now I'm thinking of Nicki Minaj type of chords. You can learn more chords at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. I'm just going to show you a couple techniques right now. Now, we have a technique where we show you how to make chords from one note. That means we could take these notes and actually expand it into a chord. And we go over that at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. So let's turn this into a chord progression. The first thing I want to do is possibly copy these notes into the bass notes. But before we do that, that's just an option. Let's assume we're in the A natural minor scale. But if not, if you're confused, since we see a C sharp here, that means we're not in that scale. We're just going to map out the tones we have so far until we build a scale. So E. So that is our scale. A scale is just a series of notes which sound good in sequence. So we're going to copy this scale because we're going to use it as a reference point to build out our chords. Now quickly, we can't go over everything about our chord system, but go to BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory for more step-by-step videos to make it easier for you. So in short, we're going to look at A. We're going to assume this is the top note of some chord. So we're going to look at our scale reference and say, okay, if it's the top note of a chord, let's work our way backwards through the scale in order to create the chord. So we're going to skip every other note going downward because this is the highest value of the chord. So let's skip G sharp, go to F sharp, skip E, go to D, skip C sharp, and go to B. So it's B, D, F sharp. And let's make sure we have velocity on these notes. Let's start back over. Now they don't have to be seventh chords either. I'm just starting with the seventh chord. So let's start with just the triad. We're gonna do the same technique here. So it's E major here. Now don't worry about the names and nomenclature. We break all that down to simplify it for you. Okay, so we're already halfway done. Now I'm gonna use the E here as an extension of that chord. I'm not gonna change the chord. I'm just going to use it as if we're adding a note in there for melody. Okay, now we need to finish off with the C sharp chord. Again, assuming C sharp is the highest note of the chord, we're going to work down this scale, skipping every other note. So A and F sharp. So we're just using triads in this situation. Now we go over what all these terms mean. Triads, major, minor, different scale types, chord progressions, different nomenclature, the Roman numeral system. We go over all that stuff in our course material. It's called the Music Theory Essentials. So we don't leave you hanging as far as that goes. And we define all that stuff so you understand what it actually is. Let's add that to the playlist now. So now we have our chord progression. What I'm going to do is add a bass note to thicken it up. Now this is one technique we teach in Chord Magic, which is our chord-specific course. So if I copy these bass notes and pull them down an octave, hitting control down, I can expand the emotion of the chord. Now I'm going to delete the scale reference because we don't need it anymore. I'm going to copy the same chord progression over, hitting shift, left click, pull it over. Now the second time we add the bass note, I'm going to add another octave, then control down. So it feels like we're playing a bunch of chords, but really it's just the same, you know, three or four chords over and over again. So it's about getting the musicality right first. See that bass note? Now, at the end, I want to change it up. So let me show you one technique a lot of people don't use, which is changing up the end portion of a chord progression. We usually call this the turnaround. It's just an area where our ear wants to hear something different. We want to kind of make it tense so that we can resolve the tension through repeating the chord progression. Now, we go over what that means so we don't make it so chaotic, but we go over that in our Music Theory Essentials course package. And I want to go dum, bum, bum. So let's do that instead. So it looks like I need my scale again, because what I'm going to do here, and also I need to change the timing here of these notes. Okay, now I should have probably kept the scale. Let me see if I can control, no. Okay, so let's just map out the scale again. That is our scale. All I'm gonna do here is just reference the scale. You don't have to do it every single time, but it really does help, especially if you don't feel like memorizing your scales. Now we have a whole, you know, code system on how to understand what a scale is if you're unfamiliar. We go over all that type of stuff. So let's see here. At the end. Now I want to make this a chord instead of just a note playing. So we're basically going to copy this chord over. Now this is missing the D root note, so let's make sure we're playing the notes D. And all we're going to do is copy that root note and just play the bass notes as well, like we did before. So. My ear wants to hear F sharp for some reason, so let's use that as the bass line instead. And let's make sure we're copying these bass notes down an octave. Just hit control, left click and drag, hit shift to highlight, and then hit control down. So instead of playing that again, let's hear it in context. Now let's work on making it sound more interesting. Now the last chord isn't the best chord. So let me see here. Actually, I'm just gonna leave it on the C sharp instead, rather than pick another chord. Okay, so firstly, let's go into FL Keys. Let's look at this plugin and see what we can do to actually make it sound the way we want. Firstly, I always turn off detune. I don't want the piano to sound detuned. It's gonna sound like a saloon piano. You know, it sounds old and rustic. Now that's great for some genres, but not the genre today. Secondly, the stereo knob is gonna determine if you wanna spread your bass notes away from your high notes. If you turn it down, it's gonna make it a mono sound or centered sound. So as you pull it upward, you're gonna hear the bass notes towards your left and the high notes towards your right. Now that's a miking technique on pianos. You can use an imager to kind of pull in the bass back to center if you want. I'm not gonna get into that because that's beyond the scope of this video. We go over that in our mixing courses at busyworksbeats.com/mixingacademy. So there's more in depth about that. Let's just worry about some effects we can use. Let's pull up an EQ. Now I'm gonna pull up and cut out frequencies. Let's cut out first frequencies I don't like, which is around 300 Hertz. I just don't like that kind of boxy sound. So let's pull that out. Then pull up on the low end frequencies a bit, and then round it back off with the high shelf. Now we're gonna add a fruity compressor to, as they say, squash the sound. We're basically trying to make the piano sound like it has a little more either a transient energy or just a very flushed out sound. So let's drop our threshold, change our ratio to 2:1 so we can hear the compression. Now it's very common to give the piano transient energy so it can cut through. So we're leaving an attack of 15 milliseconds. If you don't know what compression is, type in how to mix beats easily, BusyWorks Beats. We go over this type of stuff for free. So now let's just work on the threshold and pull up the makeup gain. Let's also try a higher ratio. Now one kind of workaround, since I haven't found a great solution FL based, is open up Maximus. Now the only thing about this is I right click and go to default, but I found that sometimes it can sound like you're compressing, even though I don't want to compress with this plugin. So you got to be careful here. But I go to low band and I pull the stereo separation knob to merged, which means mono. So now the bass is not going to be pan left. Pull the mids in a little bit. Now what you can do is add direct reverb. Since this reverb has a mix level, you can create a unique reverb. But what I would suggest is using an aux verb on a different track, like track 100. Let's open up Fruity Convolver and let's load up some realistic environments. Let's go to File, Load Sample. Let's go into our directory and let's find a space that we're gonna like. So either chamber, a hall is probably gonna be best for a piano here. So let's go to a hall. I haven't listened to all these, so let's go to St. Paul's, mid-center. Let's open that up. Now let's turn the wet level. Now I usually leave this by default, but what we want to do is turn dry level down, okay? Because we don't want a duplicate of the sound here. Let's send track one. Let's click on track one, and let's left-click this knob here to send it a portion of the sound to the aux verb. Now it feels like it's in that space. You can pick the space if you don't like that tone. Let's work on the compression a bit. I'm gonna lower the threshold so we can hear it actually pushing the volume down. Like the mids mono. That way the piano doesn't feel like it's split, you know? But let's say you wanted a stereo sound. You can basically send this track. You can right click and go to route to this track. So it sends a duplicate of that sound to track two. And what you can do is pull everything mono on this track. You don't have to do it with Maximus. You can simply go to your mixer and turn the stereo separation to merged and then pan this hard left and then pan the other one hard right. So you get a stereo sound without the bass being on one specific side. Now this track isn't routed to the reverb, so let's send this track to the reverb as well. What we're gonna do is click on track one, right click, copy that value. Go to track two, right click, and paste the value to track 100. That's a makeshift way of doing it. You could also duplicate plugin. There's many ways to do the same thing. Because here you can see there's a little lag. So there's a bunch of different solutions for that problem. I'm actually not going to do that solution, but I just wanted to show you in case that's what you wanted to do. Let's reroute it. All right, now some other effects you can add is Fruity Delay. You don't want to go ham with this. It depends on the genre and depends on the song. Let's put it on ping pong mode so it pans left and right. And then set the time to 4 or 2. Gives the piano a little more motion. move the EQ after the compressor for a lot of different reasons. Raise the second one up an octave just so we can hear it sound a little bit different. So if you want to learn more music theory techniques, as in how to build a chord progression from scratch, you can literally build chords from one note, deriving from one note. We show you how to do that. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. I'll leave a link in the video description, so you can click that link to get started now. We have a lot of free videos waiting for you, as well as project files. So thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.